Hi, I'm Zach.
And I'm Karen. Welcome to another awesome episode of the Control Cabinet Classroom. Today, we're going to talk about industrial power supplies, specifically regulated power supplies.
So let's start there. What do we mean by a regulated power supply? These types of power supplies contain internal components that ensure a consistent or regulated output voltage, regardless of the input voltage. But why is a consistent output voltage that important?
Well, typically in industrial control cabinets, the devices running off a power supply must operate within a specific voltage range. If the voltage goes above or below a device's operating range, the device could overheat, shut off, or be damaged. That could shut down an assembly line, conveyor belt. Long story short, it could be really bad.
In other words, regulated power supplies offer a better level of confidence when it comes to keeping equipment up and running properly. Now, within the world of regulated power supplies, there are two main types: linear regulated and primary switch mode power supplies.
Both types of power supplies are very good at providing clean and stable DC voltage. This is important for sensitive equipment, like high-speed data acquisition systems, that require precise voltage input.
But linear regulated power supplies offer their stability at a cost. Linear supplies are not very efficient because the transformer used to regulate the output voltage emits a great deal of heat, which translates to wasted energy. And if you recall from our previous videos, heat is the enemy of electronic equipment.
This is the main drawback of using a linear regulated power supply. Heat sinks, like this one, are used to dissipate heat from the power supply. However, that heat transfers into the cabinet, causing higher ambient temperatures. This means you need to use a larger cabinet or active cooling, both of which add cost.
On the other hand, we have primary switch mode power supplies. A primary switch mode power supply uses a microprocessor-based circuit to regulate the power. In doing so, the internal circuitry of this power supply is more advanced, since both the input and the output voltage of the power circuit are rectified and filtered.
There are two distinct advantages of using primary switch mode power supplies. First, they accept a wide range of input voltage. For example, the Quint power supply I'm holding will take anywhere from 100 to 240 volts AC, as well as 110 to 250 volts DC. So this power supply will take any voltage within those ranges and convert it down to the safe and universal level of 24 volts DC.
The second advantage of using a switch mode power supply is the compact size. You can see these two power supplies look very similar, but what you can't see is their difference in power and weight. This is a 2.5 amp, 24 volt, 60 watt switch mode power supply. And this is a 1 amp, 5 volt, 5 watt linear regulated supply. So the switch mode supply is 12 times more powerful than the linear supply, and it's significantly lighter. The linear regulated power supply does make a nice chicken tenderizer though. Karen, if you will.
Wow, that really does work.
I might take this home. That's done. Thanks, Karen. Cook that later.
In summary, both types of regulated power supplies will give you clean, accurate DC output voltage. Primary switch mode power supplies have become the standard in industrial applications. They handle a wide range of voltage inputs, run cool, and are extremely efficient, all in a compact housing.
If you like this video, please give us a big old thumbs up before you click onto something else. And after you're done tenderizing your chicken, be sure to use that linear regulated power supply to smash the subscribe button below, so you get all our new videos as they're released. As always, we'll see you next time.